What up, y'all? This is John Regal, aka Illa J. This is my interview with Patrick Lane at thewordisbond.com. Yeah, so, you know, I'm gonna do a ghetto style. I wrote the questions right next to me. I'm gonna look at them and then I'm gonna answer the questions. So, here you go.
Birthday of the year. Get ready, get set, go.
What does the hip hop seem like in Detroit right now? Well, right now it's on the rise. I mean, you got a lot of people. You got your Danny Browns, your Black Milks, Black and Brown, L, Slum, Illa J, Big Sean, and you know, that's just to name a few. Guilty Simpson. It's a lot of people coming up in the D right now. And who should people look out for? Like I said, you know, of course, Guilt, Black, I mean, Danny Brown, Black and Brown, T3, Young RJ, Slum, Vice. Yeah, you know, like I said, these is, you know, Frank and Dank. I mean, come on. I mean, that's fam. So, what was it like filming the Won't Do video? All right, okay, so that was a really good experience. It was, you know, definitely like life changing in the sense that, you know, I was just going to college and, like, you know, my brother passes, and then later on in the year, that's when I shot the video or whatever. And I remember BBE calling up me and my moms, and they were asking us, like, you know, what should be the single for the album. And, like, that song, I've known that song for at least about four, that song's at least about 4 or 5 years old, you know, and that was always one of my favorite songs. And as soon as I heard it, I was like, you know, amongst all the tracks on the album, like, that was a for sure deal. I mean, come on, one won't do, that was it. When did you first hear the beat and write to it? Well, when I first heard the beat, I heard the whole song together. So you know that, like, you know, some people were getting mixed up because I remember people thinking it was my brother in the video, you know, and then people realized that's his younger brother. Like, oh, yeah, it's me, but it's not my song. So you see, people got that mixed up too. They thought it was my song because they saw me in the video, but it was like last minute. They were asking me, you know, who. They were trying to put the video and the treatments together, and they asked me if I would play my bro. And I'm like, of course, you know what I mean? Like, that's my hero. Of course, you know, why wouldn't I rep for him, you know? So, and I don't, you know, and I was still dealing with, you know, my issues with, you know, my brother passing and stuff. So, you know, I ain't want to see no other dude playing my brother in the video, you know? I probably would've been mad about that. Tell us a funny story people might know about J Dilla or something strange. Hey, let me see, what story that I haven't told? I keep telling the same stories on all the interviews. Okay, so I'm gonna switch it up. I'm gonna tell you. I'm trying to think of a funny story, but you know what? It was a lot when I first went to LA. So like me, my brother, my boy Nick, like pulling up, and it just already was entertainment. As soon as we got there, like get to the house, and then so this delivery guy just comes up to the door. And, you know, he like, yeah, you order a Thai chicken, and my brother like, no, this is I didn't order, I ordered a pizza. I'm sorry, you know. He's like, no, this is your address. You order Thai chicken, and my brother, he just got mad. He like, yo, like look at the address outside, and the guy shows him the address, and it's not the address. He's like, yo, this is 132 Sycamore, but it's not a funny story. At least how I'm telling it, but it was funny. You know, we had like, it was a lot of funny stuff when we first went out to LA. That was fun hanging out with my bro. When can we expect the next John Regal project? Next John Regal project, aka Illa J project. You know, because I want to confuse people. John Regal is just another way for me expressing myself and, you know, me stepping out of the box and continue to expand myself as an artist, you know. And so all different genres, all types of areas, you know, working with artists that, you know, work with before, working with grooves I wouldn't work with before, just, you know, continuing to expand as an artist. But definitely mixtape coming up soon. If you check out my SoundCloud/John Regal, you know, matter of fact, just click on to my Twitter. I'm Twitter at Illa J, ILLAJ, and you know, if you go on my page, you can click on my SoundCloud, and you know, I got put a lot of, if anything says download, that means free. So yeah, feel free to cop some of the new music. I'll be working with Slum Village. You know, yes, I am Slum Village official. So, you know, yeah, a lot of new music. Franklin Dang, T3, Young RJ, a lot of us got new music come out. So keep checking out for that Detroit vibe. Yeah. What advice can you give people looking to get into the music industry? Oh, that's a tough one. All I can say is, one, patience. you need patience. Definitely, you got to have that patience because, you know, it's going to be ups and downs. It's going to be slow sometimes. But once it starts moving. You know what I mean? Just remember, the fastest pace is one step at a time. A lot of people want to skip steps trying to get to success. And it just doesn't work. I'm telling you, the fast way is one step at a time. You know, take. Just work hard and continue to work at your own pace. And eventually, one step, one pace at a time, you know, you start, you crawling, next thing you know, you're walking, you're running, next thing you know, you're flying. You know, wow. I looked up to my bro, Michael Jordan, and I think they both have in common is that work ethic and that drive to continue to, no matter what, you know, and I'm on it, you know, I'm continuing to top myself. I know I'm not comfortable, I can do better. And, you know, that's what it's about, you know. It's like beginners think they know everything, and the professionals always trying to find ways to get better. And that is as simple as that. So, yeah, just keep that in mind and listen to your heart. That's all I can say. For artists, what you'd love to work with in the future? Oh, of course, Little Dragon, at Little Dragon. Please tweet at LaJ whenever you get a chance. I definitely want to do a track with you, for real. Debbie Nova, we got to do something else. Sounds Like Love, that was a fun record. We'd love to do another record with you. Nico Gray, Black Milk, yo, I mean, collaboration, come on, yo. I'm trying to see Danny Brown, obviously Frank Nick, QD, Dan Carr, Eunice, this chick Eunice, she can sing, she's really dope. And, you know, it's a lot of people I gotta, you know, I wanna work with. But those of you that don't know, why does Frank Nitti think that you're an alien? Okay, so you're talking about the skit. So I have this album called Yancey Boys, if you know, put out by Delicious Vinyl. Shout out to Mike Ross and Rick Ross. But I have an interlude on my album, Yancey Boys, all produced by my bro. And this is one interlude where Frank Nitti is talking about my family, and everybody in my family sings, which is true. And, you know, everybody's musically talented, and, like, artists and stuff. Like, even my niece, my 11-year-old niece, she'll be 12 this December. And, you know, watch out. Like, you might see my niece on X Factor. It's coming up here in 2012. I'm going to get on X Factor. I'm telling you, she can sing. I don't know. I mean, even if I was an alien, I wouldn't tell anybody. They try to do experiments on my brain. And you know, I tell you that my brother was, though, if that gives any hints or clue. One more question. Yeah, my ghetto interview, me going to my notebook, and I wrote down the questions. When is the new J Dilla Rebirth of Detroit album coming out, and will I be on it? Yes, I will be on it. Do I know the date? I don't know. But I can assure you that, you know, I'll be on it, and, you know, maybe it might be something slum on it. But, you know, it's going to be a dope project. I support it, and, you know, hope that you support it too. And definitely, when I do know the official dates and everything, when it's coming out, I'll definitely let you know. So, yeah. Again, hit me up, Twitter, at ILLAJ. Let me say it again. Twitter, at ILLAJ. Twitter, at LJ. What plans do you have to tour in 2011? Well, it's kind of the end of the year now, but somehow I'm still touring. Next week, technically a week and a half or whatever, I'll be going to Chile. Me and Frank Nick going to do Chile December 2nd. Then I come home for two or three days, and then after that, Brazil, me, T3RJ, for the slum tour, started a world tour. So, yeah, you know, just starting to get around and stuff. But, I mean, honestly, like, this year was a fun year in touring. I did a lot over in Europe. You know, we did Paris, London, we did Austria. We did a lot of Europe countries this year. It was fun. We hit the West Coast a lot, East Coast. So, you know, definitely we're going to be around, and it's going to be even crazier this 2012 year coming up. I rep my Detroit fam, and I think Detroit is officially back on the map, officially about to be Motown status again. You know, just watch. Detroit, we coming. Let's go. And, you know, that was my interview with Patty Lane at thewordisbond.com. Your boy Illa J, Yancey Boys, let's go. On my balls. Aha, you let me psych you out. Kiss, bang, bang. Now I knocked you out.